Welcome to Update News. Online. The route of the Wilmington Grand Prix will pass right in front of a city landmark that, for the first time in decades, is open to the public. The Old Queen Theater at 5th and Market Streets has been completely refurbished and finally reopened on April 1st as World Cafe Live at the Queen. Here's a look at the huge steps taken to bring her back to life.
It was April of 1959. The movie was The House on Haunted Hill, a Vincent Price thriller. No one in the audience that day could possibly know that they were seeing the last moments of a dying queen. The echoes of this final audience would bounce around an empty shell for more than 50 years. It had been five long decades since the doors had been shuttered on the tired old Queen Theater.
And nearly 100 since the fire in 1910 caused her to be rebuilt. Much like that house in the Vincent Price movie, the Queen was the ghost that haunted Market Street.
There were three theaters at one point on this 500 block. So there was one next to Old Town Hall, there was one across the street, and then the Queen Theater. It's hard for us to imagine, and really if you think that until World War II, 4th and Market Street was the busiest intersection in the city, and that's where all the buses stopped, that's where really everything was happening. So even though the business moved up there, Wilmington's heart was still down here in some ways. And there were theaters as far down as a 200 block during this period of the 1920s, 1930s, and the heydays. Then what happens is after World War II, everybody really begins in droves to move out to the suburbs. And that's really when the city theaters start to die out, the city restaurants start to die out, and people don't come downtown so much, except for during the day, and they may go to Woolworths and visit the lunch counter during the day, but everybody moves home, and that was the start, really, of the demise of life, cultural life on Market Street, except for a few shining exceptions, of course.
Sometimes, and it may take a lifetime, things change. They always do. The hawking, decaying building that had been forgotten so long ago is alive again, and her revival carries with her the hopes and dreams of developers, and politicians, and residents. This majestic queen can once again breathe life into the heart of a city. When brothers Rob and Chris Puccini bought the building in 2007, they had a vision of what Wilmington could be, but it seemed a long way off. They had done this before, crafting the new Christina waterfront out of abandoned factories and a desolate riverway. But this would be different. The heart of downtown already existed, but the beat had slowed. There were already a few gems here, most notably the Grand Opera House, but it was hard to imagine Market Street humming along with activity every day and every night. As workers piled into their cars and headed for the suburbs, they took the lifeblood of downtown with them. Wilmington needed a way to hold on to the vibrancy that overtook the city each morning. The Puccini brothers figured out a way. They would invest in the city, buying up properties that were blighted or underused, and they would bring back the heart. What they needed was the Queen. What they found was Hal Real. In 2004, Real opened World Cafe Live in an industrial area of Philadelphia. It was a gamble that paid off, and he was looking to expand. Among all of his options, Wilmington was the clear choice. But why?
First of all, its proximity to all of our fans and the XPN fans in the greater Philadelphia market was very attractive. So it's not a brand new idea to a lot of folks around here. It's an idea they already knew about and were excited to have it be much more accessible. So for everybody who lives in the western suburbs of Philly or in Philly itself, all the way into Chester County and obviously northern Delaware, Maryland, and a lot of New Jersey, this is a great accessible place. Secondly, we want to provide more options to our fans. So this way, on any given night, there's not just two shows in Philly, there's four shows between Philly and Wilmington, and lots of choices. I think that Wilmington has tremendous, historically, tremendous impact and lots to be proud about and should feel that way for the future. But this isn't just about the future. It's happening right now. You can't just have businesses in Wilmington where people come into town at 9 and leave at 5, where people live in Philadelphia and commute to Wilmington. Wilmington needs to be Wilmington. It needs to have its own nightlife and its own daytime. The threads are all there to weave the same kind of fabric we've woven in Philly. We're already doing great collaborative things with wonderful partners here, for-profit and non-profit.
It has taken a lot of hands to bring her back to life, Public and private supporters partner with Real Entertainment Group, the Buccini Poland Group, the City of Wilmington, and the Light of the Queen Foundation to raise more than $25 million, enough money to jumpstart the hopes of a city that has taken its share of lumps in the past.
As you start to form these partnerships and do cool things together, it just sort of has a ripple effect that should ripple out through the community and make it a much more vibrant place again.
At one point, I was doing some research on Market Street, and a person who was a very young girl said, well, you would go downtown because you wanted to see, but you also wanted to be seen. And we've lost that. And so with the dynamics of the Grand Opera House and the World Cafe, that's a kernel, isn't it, for people maybe to come down here and to see people and maybe to be seen if you're a young person, because you're out there looking for a little bit of life.
Ground was broken for the new Queen in October of 2009. Since then, workers rebuilt what they could and restored the rest.
What it has become is a melding of the past with a functional and elegant present. The theater's original balcony is still there, albeit with new seating and a place to dine or party. It's part of Downstairs Live, a hall that can accommodate 400 seated or 800 standing audience members. The stage has retained the weathered look of a beauty that has seen better days, but she can still dazzle you whenever she wants to. Equipped with the latest audio-visual technology, World Cafe Live at the Queen will be able to broadcast events to the world through a partnership with WXPN Radio in Philadelphia, which syndicates the World Cafe music program to over 170 public radio stations. Just a few steps from the front of the building, which retains the facade from the Queen's earlier incarnation as a movie theater, is the entrance to Upstairs Live. This intimate 150-seat room is home to a bar, a restaurant, and most importantly, a stage. On April 1st, 2011, on a site that was once an apartment building, a gym, a vaudeville theater, and a movie theater, the brand new World Cafe Live at the Queen opened her doors for business, and business is booming. In the weeks since the ribbon cutting, the Queen has lured thousands of visitors inside for lunch, dinner, presentations, and concerts.
For everyone involved, the hope is that this wave of interest carries over and transforms Market Street back into what it once was, the region's hub for culture, arts, and entertainment. Reporting for Update News, this is Paul Kennard.
This is Update News.